tell us about the methodology of the mantra, the Hare Krishna mantra. How does that, what is the theory behind how this mantra actually does what it does?
Again, let's go to the Shastras. There's Kali Santarna Upanishads, which is part of Krishna Yajurveda. There this mantra is given in this particular form. And Brahma tells Narada that this is Sarva Shruti Rahasya Gopyam. I'll give you something which is Sarva Shruti Rahasya Gopyam. Something which is a secret of all the Shruti and very confidential. Okay. Then he says, Bhagavata Adi Purushasya Narayanasya Nama Uchcharana. And then he says, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. By Nama Uchcharana, by uttering these names, next he says that 16 layers of ignorance will get around the soul, will get dissolved, just like a cloud vanishes and sunlight comes out. In the same way, our consciousness, our pure consciousness comes out by associating with this name. So, now, just like God has a form in the spiritual world, He has name also. So just like form can take avatara, His name can take an avatara. The vibration that me and you chant with our tongue, obviously it's a material vibration. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, because it's produced by the tongue. But there is something unseen happening, because the Lord has willed Kalikale Krishna Nama Rupa Avatara. He enters into this sound, identical sound, so that when you hear the sound, you are hearing His absolute transcendent aprakrita sound. So there is prakrita sound, which is, I am vibrating with my tongue. There is aprakrita sound, which is the eternal sound, which is descending into this mantra. So through the medium of this prakrita sound, I am touching the aprakrita sound. And aprakrita sound is an ocean of Satchitananda. Is non-different from the Lord. So you get purified. So once you connect, just like Prabhupada, you see, when he was going to America in the ship, I mean, he went in a ship, cargo ship, and he had, you know, two heart attacks. And he wrote a very moving poem where he said, so many things he said. In the end he said, I do not know, my Lord, why you are taking me to this world full of Rajaguna and Tamoguna. You must be having a plan. But I have one important faith. I have faith in your holy name. So Prabhupada went to America and he had faith in this holy name. It is the faith in the holy name that it can transform as revealed in the scriptures.
So I want to ask you here, if somebody is not chanting, as the jiva, but listening to an iPod, which is not a jiva. So a non-jiva mechanically producing the sound, can it produce the same effect? If it can, then all these iPods would be enlightened. then in Vaikuntha, there would be all these iPods. I mean, in fact, these iPods can outperform me because they're more accurate. They can just go on and on.
Also, we don't have to spend so much time.
Right. So there must be something about the prana,
yes,
or some kind of physiology of the human being that the jeev inhabits, such that it is not the mechanical sound that counts, but something which involves life,
yes,
doing it.
That is called attention. Unless there is attention.
Right. Which is a conscious act.
Conscious action.
Which an iPod doesn't have.
Doesn't
because
have.
Because it's not a person.
Exactly.
That's where the person comes in.
Person comes in. Only person has attention.
Right.
So with attention, you should hear and chant the holy name.
So, a person, the jiva, has this connection with the supreme person.
Yes.
Both are persons.
Both are persons.
Persons. Therefore, the non-person, the non-jiva iPod can't do this.
Can't do this. Just can't do it.
This is a question which floored many gurus. When I asked them, that what happens if, why aren't, if you're doing this mantra, some meditation, whatever they're doing, will it work if the robot is doing it? And they said, they couldn't. I said, if it would, then one day Amazon will be bringing a robot delivered. There'll be a pandit who will come. This robot will come, open up, and put on some hat and all that, and you'll be able to order the pandit of your choice, what kind of dress he wants, what accent, and he'll come and he'll perform.
It does not have.
But it won't work.
It does not have the chitta.
It does not have the chitta.
Chitta is a 24th element in Sankhya.
So this virtual pandit won't work.
Won't work.
Good.
Doesn't have consciousness. So
on that we should conclude, because I've been just told that time is up and there's a very important event happening.
Yeah, right.
But let's say this is an intermission and we're going to continue this discussion further, because I'm so delighted, I'm so honored, and I'm blessed to be able to do this. Have a seat.
Thank you so much. I'm very happy that you came all the way and spend this much time with us.
This is really wonderful.
Giving us an opportunity,
and I will
to
tell you,
present Prabhupada.
Whenever I go to an ISKCON temple, anywhere in the world, not only the food is unbeatable, but the love you get and the atmosphere, the vibrations, is extremely, to me, it's very distinct. I can feel something very special.
Because we are personalists.
Yes. Yes, thank you.
Rajiv Malhotra ji, Madhupandit Das ji, I think you can already see our audience is, like, I don't see anybody who's not on the edge of their seats right now. This discussion has been so satiating to listen to. Today, the fact that we've witnessed such amazing questions as well as answers, and the clarity with which the questions were discerningly asked, as well as the immediate arrival at the essence of the answer, definitely only reflect the rare and precious clarity that Srila Prabhupada has given us access to. Thank you so much for your time and for exchanging the ideas and words that you have today. I now request His Grace Sriman Madhupandit Dasa to present Rajiv Malhotra ji with temple honors as a token of our appreciation.